Alright guys, we're back here at Elizabeth South, and today I'll take you through a chest workout. But first, let's check out the awesome gym. Let's go. Look at all that sheep. Sorry, what did I say? Welcome to Elizabeth South. So my pre-workout meal today is like a moderate carb day, so I'll typically have some form of pasta, chicken breast, beans, peas. Most important is the eggs, because on a moderate to low carb day, my protein and my fats will increase. So that's quite it for meal two for my macros. For the eggs are one of my staple in my diet. I won't really have them every day, but definitely on my low carb or my moderate carb days. Right here you see it's actually 5 whole eggs. So you just gotta put it with olive oil. Very simple, get it done. For my protein, I'll have usually a mixture of beef, chicken and fish. But today we're going 300 grams of chicken breast and 280 grams of basa fish. So that's around like something like a white fish. And on other days I'll try to go salmon. But salmon is rather expensive, so we try to ration on that. So guys, this is the retail area of the gym. So all your supplements are on there. And we got really some cool stuff here. Olympia Gym caps, stringers, rider wear, all your drinks and stuff. And all the awesome apparel here. Guys, girls. Really good stuff. And don't forget the high protein ice cream. Yeah. One thing I really love about this gym is the architecture. Like if you're a design student, you would definitely understand and appreciate it. Check out this awesome door, man. Exposed concrete. I mean, not concrete, sorry. So this deadlifting area platform is really cool because you feel like you're in outdoor space. So the light just filters in. It becomes really atmospheric. Especially when you want to train, you don't want to train in a very enclosed space. Sounds all good talk. Just push it up. Check this out, man. So the really different thing about this gym is that they have this exclusive outdoor area, which you don't see nowadays in a lot of gyms. It's really like back in Arnold's era in the old days. So if you really look closely, you see like the dumbbells, everything, they're all like rusted and stuff. But it gives those hardcore people, you know, that feel that they don't want to train in a commercial gym anymore. So you got your dumbbells, your barbells, preacher curls, incline bench, flat bench, all your back exercises, pec deck, you got your squat rack, you got your boxing bags, tricep extension cables, everything you need, really, like your dips. You have an old school leg press, like those you see in those Africa Instagram. You have your hack squat, hamstring curl, leg extension, calf raise. You even have a functional training area here. So tire flips, you got a standing calf raise, you have your battle ropes. So really this gym has like probably everything the other gyms would also have, just that it's really an outdoor area. Because you really want to get it to, you know, your workout really, you want to get it to be like pumped up and you don't want to be cold. So it's really important to have a good environment before you choose a gym to work out in. And I'll definitely recommend Olympia Gym. So right now we're doing dumbbell flies, and we're going pretty heavy today. We're going to hit around 8 to 12 reps, really hit the hypertrophy range. Sometimes we do really high reps for flies, but today we're going
much lower for a change. Like I said, we don't have a fixed routine. We just go as how we feel. That way the body is not ready for a new workout. Come on, Jordan. Area now, and we're gonna do incline bench to really hit the upper chest that most people neglect. Most people are too caught up with flat dumbbells, flat bench, machine bench, everything works the middle chest. But if you really want to get that huge upper chest, just like Arnold, we gotta keep hitting the inclines, so there's no excuse. So, incline bench press. Doesn't matter how warmed up you feel you are or how strong you are, always start with a lightweight. It's never gonna do you good, and people are gonna think you know, you have too much ego or lifting too much heavyweight in the gym. Especially if you get like more experience, the bigger you get, people tend to forget actually the more fragile you are, because you're gonna lift heavier. So you always wanna warm up. Get a good set of high reps there. Old school ghetto. Let's go. Like I was saying about the architecture, check out the underside of the roof decking. They really have taste when they design it. All matte black. The lighting, and then you have that elegant I-beam that's express. And it really just creates a just that simple feature just creates a new feel to the entire interior design of the whole gym, because the whole gym is like red and yellow and black express stuff. So what you want to do is really bring out the qualities in the gym. So right now we're blasting chest. One of the staple exercises, as I mentioned, is the flat bench. So what you want to do is really keep your reps moderate to low, and really go easy on this exercise, because it's a compound movement. And thing is not to focus on the speed of the rep and go fast, but rather control it. Doing a 5x5 program today. The other day we did a 3x6, so we'll see how it goes. Let's go, man. Come on. Strong, let's go. Good. Good. Easy. Easy. Come on. One more, one more. Come on. Up. Great. Nice. So right now we're doing a drop set immediately after the last set of the 5x5. Just something that we kind of modify sometimes into our program. We don't really have a fixed program, which is what keeps the body guessing. And so now the weight drops by half, but the reps increase double. So at least 10 reps. Just rep it out, pump it out, get that maximum blood flow into the chest.
One of the bread and butter exercises for chest is really the flat bench. But a lot of people get caught up with numbers. So like, how much do you bench, bro? How much do you bench, this and that? It's not really about how much you bench, but it's how you bench. So the way you wanna activate that chest, you really gotta do a constant squeeze. So if you see the videos, I actually went down slow and try to explode at the top, get that full contraction on the chest muscle.
Now we move back indoors again, and this time we're doing a different variation of the pec deck. This machine is really unique at Olympia Gym, and it actually makes your arms straighter, so you don't really use much delts. As you can see, Johnny's squeezing his chest with the most isolated kind of move. Due to the angles of the handle, you are literally forced to isolate.
More. Yep, yep.
Less spread.
Yep, less spread. Look up, yep. Nice.
Side chest.
Yep.
So right now we're hitting machine press. The good thing about machines is after all your compounds or even isolations, you're really fatigued, so your balancing won't be there anymore. But you still want to get an extra squeeze. So that's why we do machines. People always stay away from machines because it won't build a muscle. But that's not true, man. You gotta do all exercises, hit all angles. Let's go. Set, we're doing a triple drop set. So Johnny will show us how it's done. He's doing 30, 20 and 10 kilos. So stripping 10 kilos per set, you can really get a good squeeze on the last set. So drop sets are really essential, especially if you're alone, you want to go to that muscle failure. So you drop set so that you know that you still got everything in the tank, but you want everything out of the tank. It's really lightweight, but if you really get everything out, you'll notice that it's not about the weight, and you just go to extreme muscle failure, which is what we're really going for, to stimulate the muscle. Sometimes we do double drops, sometimes we do triple drops. Sometimes even four drops. Machine, you don't see it at every gym. It's a flat hammer strength for chest. It's really, really good for the squeeze. And this time we're gonna aim for 10 reps everything, but we're gonna do pause reps. So pause reps are really different. It stops the momentum at the bottom, and then you explode at the top to get that squeeze without any jerking of the weight. What we're doing now is a final set, and it's a really a set where you squeeze every fiber out, every last remaining fiber. So we're doing pause reps, so you stop at the bottom and explode at the top. As you can see, Johnny is taking it to true failure. In addition to the pause reps, we're going to do a drop set pause rep. So 10 reps, strip the weight, then another 10 reps. So it's really light, But trust me, it's a killer and you guys should try it out. Come on, failure, failure. Start with the bottom. Outside the shed area, and we're doing the old school pec deck. So Johnny will show us again how it's done. Now we're really gonna hit all kinds of rep ranges. So for this set, we will do everything 12 reps, 5 working sets at least. Because for our other exercises, we hit 8 to 10, you know, 5 reps, 15 reps, 20 reps, but we haven't hit the 12 rep range, which is near the hypertrophy range. So it's really important that you hit all rep ranges, especially if you really want to get a good pump. Okay. Back to the left arm. This is nice. So that is fine. What's here? Keep holding it, holding it, holding it. Nice. Okay. That's right.
Alright, right here at Olympia Gym, we have a two specific supplements that actually are really good. Both are primal whey protein and a mammoth mass gainer right here. And this is anabolic nutrition. So these are the more popular supplements that they are selling right here at Olympia Gym. First, I'll talk about the whey protein here. So this is just a typical whey protein, but the difference that this whey protein has from other whey protein is it has a higher dose of BCAAs and glutamine, as you can see here. Right, and so the macros are really not too bad. They're actually 30 grams of protein,
1 gram of fat and just 4 grams of carbs. So it's a relatively clean and lean protein for people who are looking for that lean muscle, and you don't want too much, you know, sugars and carbs into your whey shake. Right, the next one. Oh, and the serving size would be 40 grams, and it has 25 serves for one container like this. The next one is actually, I was quite surprised when I saw this mass gainer, because most mass gainers really go for high carbs, you know, the normal protein, and really just pumping it up. But this one has a 50-50 blend of carbs and protein, so it's, I think, for people who actually want to really get that bulk, but you don't want to pull on too much unnecessary fat. Because the macros are actually really quite clean. They only have 1 gram of fat, 27 grams of carbs, and the protein is a standard about 27 grams as well. Another good thing about this is that, as you can see here, it's loaded with glutamine and also creatine and arginine. So you don't have to actually buy those three products separately, which would actually cost more if you buy all separately. You take the pure creatine or arginine and the glutamine itself. But this one has all three in one, so it's actually a really good blend considering the macros. So yeah, these are the supplements that Anabolic Nutrition has. So we finished chess, getting in our post-workout meal, shake, solid food, and so same thing, good fats, protein, and my pasta, my carbs, and my veggies. Natural food still better than all the supplements that you want to take, so I would advise you to stick to it. So I really had a good session here at Olympia Gym. If you have the time, come here down and check it out. It's at Elizabeth South. And yeah, I'll catch you guys next time.
Hey, see you, man. Thank you.
Have a good time.
On the way back to the city, just dead, man, just so tired. It's almost sunset.